Thanks for calling.
60 seconds.
Okay. Move that all the way up to 8. No, 8.
That's just lovely. Who's got the duct tape?
Get your shirt so clean.
Never mind. Just use the backup, all right? Thank you.
Ancient Chinese secret, huh?
Everybody, just hold on.
Yeah.
Excuse me. I have a trivia question. How many people are playing the game today? We're playing solo. All right, then. Let's have a name.
I need a wet nap. Pronto.
One other thing. Are you looking for a full 21 question game or more like a, you know, a 7 question dealy? Okay, fine. Okay, you want to buzz in on the letter B. That's B as in Last of the Bohicans.
Ow! Kill the goose lamp on too. Thank you.
20 seconds.
Here, try it.
What the hell happened?
Hey, we got 20. All right. A question comes on the screen. You think you know the answer, you buzz in, you pick one of the choices on the screen. You with me? Good.
10 seconds.
Good luck to you.
Okay,
nine,
here we go, everybody. Let's lose a desktop.
Seven.
And go to
six,
black.
Five.
How about you?
Four.
Call me.
Three.
That's
1-900 Tuna. Please wait an hour after meals before calling.
It's time for the show where high culture and pop culture collide.
Hey, all right, how you doing?
Playing by yourself today, that's cool. I'll close my eyes. Okay, let's get this ball rolling. How about it, we need a category.
Let's have some fun.
Here comes question one.
Okay, coming up, this category is, who are the people in your neighborhood? And this one's worth $2,000. Help me out here. I'm trying to remember who is that guy. When you know the answer, buzz in and type the answer. You know, he's on that TV show starring the Back to the Future guy. He's the next door neighbor. And he's friends with the son and in love with one of the daughters. And he has a really silly name. Who is he? Let me take a second of my time to show you what's right. Skippy! His real name is Irwin Handelman. I hear he got nicknamed Skippy because he once covered himself in peanut butter and asked Mallory to be his jelly. Take your pick. What do you say?
Here comes question two. It'll make you feel brand new.
The category. Diddle this. Two G's for a right answer. Hang on tight, cause here we go. Hey diddle diddle, the cat and the fiddle, the cow did a paradiddle. What? A paradiddle is a drum roll pattern that goes left, right, left, left, right, left, right, right, etc. You know, I was a drummer, I know that. And I understand the cow's going on tour with Bo Diddley. Alright, go ahead and pick one.
Put on your pens for the naked dance.
Three!
The category is, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Get this right, get $2,000. Okay, take a shot at this. What's the best formula for finding Broca's area? Strip naked and use a ruler. Rip open Broca's area as part of the brain that controls the mechanics of speech. So the next time one of your friends mispronounces a word, feel free to rip open their skull and start poking around. Come on, we need a
shaking up the floor, shaking up the floor.
And this category is a match made in Studio 7. This one's gonna be $3,000. Okay, let's imagine this bizarre scenario. Match game host Gene Rayburn won't start the show unless the reading on his Celsius. It's negative 40 degrees when Gene Rayburn hits the stage. Although I hear the real reason Gene doesn't leave his dressing room is cause Fanny Flagg's outside. Okay, pick a category. Uh-oh. chess, but sits grime floor.
It's time for
Tinkerlick Test Run.
The category for this gibberish question: the flight of the bumblebee. And this opening value is going to be worth $5,000. Now, you're going to have about 30 seconds to solve this puzzle, and I'm going to be taking away a little bit of cash every second and a half. Okay, now tell me, with what famous phrase does this rhyme? Use some B-salve, the throb numb, and don't be throbbed up by the punctuation. First clue, it's a line from a movie. A movie about the space program.
It's coming out of my stomach!
Third clue, hey NASA. Okay, go for it. Type in your answer. I guess this is where I make a crack about you having the right stuff. Pick your pick. What do you say?
Oh, this is really big.
This thing is huge!
Category, let's do it. It's a bird. It's a plane. It's a German physicist. $3,000 for this one. Imagine Superman and his pal William Röntgen are tossing a few back at a local pub one night. In order to get some free drinks out of him, Superman would be able to impress his buddy William Röntgen by doing which of the following feats? Lifting the entire bar with his finger, levitating from his chair, looking through the back. The Man of Steel's X-ray vision might impress William Röntgen, who discovered X-rays. I guess that explains Lois Lane's frilly lead under things. How about it? We need a... The category is, show me that thing you do. Okay, $3,000 coming at ya. Check this out. If Manny, your merry mixed drink making maid, has his meniscus on display for everyone to see, what's his real problem? He has his fly open, he's bald, he's pouring too much into his drinks, or he's smiling so hard his gums are showing. Too bad you didn't choose this. That extra bulge of water at the top of a full glass. That's a meniscus. But I gotta tell you, I don't really feel comfortable talking about another man's bulge, you know? Alright, go ahead and pick one.
Here's why we hate number 8.
Alright, next up. Not so sterling silverware. $2,000 riding on this one. Remember that nursery rhyme, hey diddle diddle, the cat and the fiddle, where the dish ran away with the spoon? Well, if after eloping the dish found out that the spoon's little utensil was also shaped like a spoon, what would be the best way for her to describe it? Spatulate, fistulous, linear, or spoony? Spatulate can mean spoon-like. I think it can also mean an annulment. Okay, pick a category.
It's party time.
Here comes number 9.
And we call this one, 3 is a magic number. Okay, the right answer nets you $1,000. Alright, fingers limber, cuz here comes the question. Which of these groups actually has 3 members? The 3 Musketeers, 3 Dog Night, the 3 Stooges, or the 3 Amigos? Let me show you what someone smart would have picked. Once, twice, 3 times an amigo. I like the 3 amigos and a baby a lot better though. It was so heartwarming. Take your pick, what do you say? Kevin and eggs? What? I know, bacon and eggs. Kevin, bacon. Duh. I don't believe it. All right, we're going to make a celebrity collect call to the man who came up with the phrase, thank you, sir, may I have another Mr. Kevin Bacon? All right, I'm dialing up Mr. Kevin Bacon now. Hey, you know that game 6 Degrees of Kevin Bacon? I wonder if I could be linked to him within six people. Let's see. I did that carpet spot with Ruth Buzzy. That was cool.
Hello?
I have a collect call from Buzz that you don't know Jack. Will you accept the charges?
Buzz. Honey, do you know a Buzz? Buzz. Oh, Buzz. The video boy. Okay. Operator, yes. I will accept the charges, cheap bastard.
Hello?
Hey, Buzz. Buzzman. Hey.
Kevin, how you doing? Glad I got a hold of you. How's it going?
It's great. It's going great, man. But just tell me again, what are we supposed to do here? You're going to ask me some trivia questions or something like that?
You're going to ask the question, Kev. Uh-huh. Before we get to that, I just want to say that I'm a huge fan of yours. Uh-huh. I mean, I've seen everything that you've done. Animal House, Diner, The Big Picture, Apollo 13. You've done everything.
Yeah. You know, I draw the line at janitor and CD-ROM game show host. No offense.
None taken. So, Kev, what do you say about writing a question for us? You know, it won't take a long time. Probably as long as that cameo you had in Planes, Trains, and Automobiles.
Whoa, I think you know a little too much about my career, man. Can you say restraining order?
Restraining order? Listen, Kev, what do you think? Can you come up with a question for us?
Yeah, why not?
Cool.
Listen, it doesn't have to be about movies, does it?
Nah, you can do whatever you want. Listen, I'm going to put you on the phone with Cookie. You guys can talk about a question, and I'll see you in a bit. Sound good?
As long as your check clears, it sounds great.
Don't worry, it'll clear, hopefully. All right, we're going to be back with Kevin Bacon. For now, let's pick another category. Come on, we need a category.
Hey, Master Blaster! Won't you find an answer? It's 10!
This one's gonna be Centipedes and Spy Hunters. Get it right, get 2,000 bucks. Help me out here. I can't remember the name of that game. Now, when you know the answer, buzz in and type in your answer. It was a video game that had that little orange guy with the big nose. And he jumped around on that... Okay, let's see... Q-Bert. Weren't those old video game characters lame? Hey, has anyone seen my Earthworm Jim cartridge? Well, round one is done. Let's dive into round two. Okay, pay attention, because all the questions in round two are worth more money. Hey, we're back on our Celebrity Collect Call with Kevin Bacon. All right. Kevin, are you there?
Hold on. Buzz? I'm sorry about that. You there?
Yeah, I'm here, Kev. Was that your wife, Kira Sedgwick, you were talking to?
Yeah.
Is it possible I could talk to her?
Well, whoops. Oh, darn. She just left the room, Buzz.
Oh.
Listen, look, maybe next time, all right?
Oh, well. How about that question, Kev? Let her rip.
All right. Here we go. Here's the question.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
The category is the other white...
And we're going to make this one worth 5,000 teats.
Imagine that during the movie Footloose, my foot actually comes loose and falls to the ground. Now, assuming that I were actually made of bacon, which disease might I contract if I were to eat my own uncooked foot? Periodontitis, trichinosis, halitosis, or scurvy?
Kevin, they picked trichinosis.
You got it. If I had eaten my raw, uncooked, bacony foot, I could have gotten an infestation of tiny larvae known as Trichinella spiralis. I could have even died, and then I never would have been able to travel into space to be thrown up on by Bill Paxton.
Kevin, that was a great question. It was awesome and nauseating at the same time. Look, if you ever want to give up this acting thing, there's a job here waiting for you, writing questions.
Oh, that's quite an offer, Buzz. But you know what? I'd sooner gouge my eyes out with pointy sticks than write for a video game. No offense.
Yeah, none taken. Listen, Kev, you know that game 6 Degrees of Kevin Bacon? I think I can be connected to you within six people. My uncle plays golf with Jack Lemmon. And,
I gotta go, bud. Thanks. Thanks a lot.
No problem.
Goodbye, everybody.
I guess Kira must have been calling him. All right, well, how about that, folks? Mr. Kevin Bacon, live and in person. Awesome. Okay, let's pick another category. How about it? We need a category.
12.
Category. The good parts are underlined. Get this right, you're bringing home 6K. Get your fingers ready. Here's one coming at ya. The 7th grade class of Our Lady of the Open Wound is assigned a biblical word search project. What word won't they find in the New Revised Standard Version Bible? Breast, penis, prodigal, or Christian? Let me take a second of my time to show you what's right. Though the story of the prodigal son is a well-known biblical parable, the actual word prodigal is not used in the text. I think the boys did find the words irresponsible and freeloader, though. And this question's category is Be Nice. And this one's worth $4,000. Okay, get ready to buzz in and type your answer. You know how Bill is a nickname for William and Bob is a nickname for Robert? Well, because Jack is a nickname too, I could be more formal when I tell you that you don't know Jack by saying you don't know blank. Go crazy! Jack is a nickname for John. But if we were really being formal here, I'd be wearing pants. Okay, pick a
number in your dreams. 14.
This category is games people shouldn't play. 2 G's for a right answer. Okay, get your fingers ready. Let's get busy. To get from Baltic Avenue to Mediterranean Avenue in Monopoly, you pass Community Chest. To get from the Baltic Sea to the Mediterranean Sea in the real world, you do what? Travel through Northern Africa, across Eastern Europe. You'll be traveling through Eastern Europe. Which in Monopoly terms makes Eastern Europe the crappiest property to own. How about it? The category is toilet paper and the supernatural. This one's worth $4,001 bills. Remember Mr. Whipple, that curmudgeonly grocer from the Charmin bath tissue commercials? Suppose Mr. Whipple quits his job at the grocery store to follow a religious figure who uses magic to heal the sick. What could Whipple say to protect his master from troublesome admirers? Please don't squeeze the salmon. Please don't squeeze the shaman. Please don't squeeze the Brahma, or please... A shaman uses supernatural powers to heal people. Excuse me, ladies, please don't squeeze the shaman.
But Mr. Whipple, your shaman is so squeezably soft.
Your pick. Excellent choice. It's time to play Dis or Dat. Here's a category for this Dis or Dat. My evil twin. Okay, concentrate. I'm gonna... Oh, you already know what you're doing. Okay, give me 30 seconds on the clock then. Let's do it. Mr. Roper from Three's Company, one actor or two. Garrett from Bewitched. Lionel Jefferson. Uncle Charlie. Chris Partridge. Becky from Roseanne. Last one. That's all 7. All right. That's about a C+, B minus. Let's see what it does to your GPA. Hey, marginal help to your score is better than no help at all. Come on, we need a... Okay, coming up, this category is... What I do for a burrito. This one's worth $6,000. Alright, here we go. You're in Mexico City viewing a Taco Bell ad that tells you run for the border. Since you're already in Mexico, you assume you must run to the nearest bordering country, which is what? United States, Panama, Guatemala, or Cuba? From Mexico City, you'd be running some 500 miles to the Guatemalan border. Hey, could I have a burrito, please?
Sorry, dude, we're all out of burritos.
No!
All right, go ahead and pick one. The The category is iconoclastic toys. And this one's worth $2,000. Check this out. Suppose a leading toy manufacturer decides to cash in on the Sunday schooler market and release a new line of biblical toys. Which baby doll might include a woven bulrush carrying case? Isaac, Jesus, Moses, or Huey? Well, according to the story, Moses was sent adrift in a bulrush basket by his mother and was found by Egyptian princesses. The Baby Moses Dolls. Stone tablets sold separately. Okay, pick a category.
Question 19.
Category, let's do it. Hey, cool paint job. Pop a right answer, you got 4K. Hey, open your eyes and look at this picture and tell me, what would be the best name for this painting? Starry Night Rider. It's Kit, the car from Knight Rider, inserted into Van Gogh's painting, Starry Night.
Michael, my readings indicate a severe drop in our Nielsen ratings.
How about...
Superstar. You're special. 20.
The category. Immortals do it for eternity. We are talking 4 big ones. Hey, look, you're back in high school health class, and your substitute teacher is Greek goddess Athena. Imagine a girl asks Athena for advice about sex based on her personal experience. What will Athena answer? Why be tied down? I'd avoid it. Try assuming the form of a duck. Hermes delivers everything quickly, or just make sure he's a close relative. In case you're interested, here's the right answer. Athena chose to remain a virgin goddess because she didn't want to be tied down. But she was very fond of a certain olive branch. Take your pick. What do you say? Jack attack time. You've been here before. Well, hope you're prepared this time. Here's your clue. Let's get Freudian. Super. Alright, away we ego. Good luck. Whether you want to be proud or ashamed of that. Think about it while I tell you.
You don't know Jack!
Great job, everybody. Good show. Okay, let's roll the commercials and contestants. Cookie, what's happening?
So you're on the high scoreboard of You Don't Know Jack. And to be this good at trivia must mean that you have no life. And, you know, I'm not proud of you. I pity you, actually. But hey, you gotta be good at something. And if you wanna exercise your talent a little more, just tell me when you wanna play again.
Miami Beach Mindy. Condo sold separately with executive Greg Dowell.
Are you troubled by the uncertainty of your future? Who isn't? Do you have questions about love, money, and career? Of course you do. My name is Rami Darfay, but you can call me Bob. Think of me as your friend who's kind of psychic. Call me at 1-900-IC. I can see into your mind. I know you want to call. Do it now. Your first three questions are free. Hello?
Is this Bob?
Yep, it is. That's one.
Are you a psychic?
Yes, I am. That's two.
Can I ask you a question?
Yes, you may. That's three. Call 1-900-IC. If you're under 18, call anyway. I can see into your parents' minds. They want you to call. Did you just have an appendectomy?